Hello, this is the RPG Check. Welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales 2 Blind. Where am I again? I'm at the island. Okay, good. I know what to do now. Nope. Not yet. We have to actually use the can with this statue. We're gonna imitate the bird again. Pretty random. Who would have thought?
Give me the compass, bird brain.
Did you say that?
I'm over here.
Nah. Be careful what you say, William.
What? William's dead. I'm talking to you. I've had enough of you and this whole charade. Give Nate what he needs and let me go.
You ungrateful tit. I told you, you're only to speak when I ask you something.
No one listens to you, fatty.
Fatty? I won't be insulted by a feathered mongrel. One more word.
Word.
And what, bird brain?
Oh, just you wait. No, come back. Come back. Who's gonna talk to me now?
Aw. I will. Ta-da!
I better not. Already. Hello?
Aye. Have they gone?
I've gotta go.
See you later.
Anyway. We can leave now.
The lady wants Ivo. I'd better not speak to her.
Alright, the bird's up there now.
I think the parrot is happy not having to play the one-man entertainer in the madhouse anymore. Hey there, little fella. Come down here. I think the parrot...
Okay, so what we do now... Now we use the seeds.
Hey, you up there. Are you hungry?
two squawks for yes.
Gotcha!
What?
I'm lucky the bird is more of an accessory and isn't a fighter like the ape.
Yeah, right. So, I think that's our gift. I think. Possibly. This thing on.
The Van Buren brat is expecting a Mad Hatter and a White Rabbit at her tea party.
Correct.
Soda Lupa?
Soda Lupa?
I've got an idea. All you've got to do is play the White Rabbit.
Soda Lupa.
Worries me a little how easy it is to persuade you to do this kind of thing.
Lutsuruluka means let's do this thing or something. Oh, he's putting powder on him now.
All right. You're white, you've got a costume on, you've got a present. It's now or never.
Awesome. Need to get a good look at him now.
May I introduce you to the White Rabbit?
Doesn't look like a normal rabbit at all.
Of course not.
Yes, well, you know.
He's special.
Gosh, it's a super rabbit.
Now you got the idea.
Only the best for your party.
Have you got a present for me, little Snuffles?
Boodaloop.
Boodaloop.
Mr. Hoppy thought you might like a rare animal from his homeland.
Mr. Hoppy.
And he talks.
Ooh! Oh, that's such a lovely present. Please, Mr. Bird, do take a seat.
How do we stop him from flying off?
Do take a seat, Mr. Hoppy. May I offer you some tea?
So, Mr. Hoppy and I are here. Wasn't your dear mother going to join us?
Uh-huh. Mommy, it's tea time. The Hatter and the Rabbit are here.
How do we...
What? It's lovely that you found someone to play with, but Mommy has to work.
How do we get her to leave?
You promised me the biggest and bestest present ever as soon as the Hatter and the Rabbit arrived.
But darling, those aren't...
I want my present now!
Meltdown.
Where is it?
But darling, we already talked about this. You mustn't get so overexcited and stop pointing that thing at me.
What's our DEFCON level?
I want my present!
Yeah.
Of course. It's, in Sea Stone.
Sea Stone?
You can choose something from the shop.
Oh.
I can't do anything here by the look of it.
Awesome. Link! Yahoo! How's the tea? he's actually just sitting there sipping the tea. That's awesome. Can we get some of this now? They're not sitting here.
Delicious. It's impossible to keep your hands off this kind of thing.
Oh my god, Nate.
I'm not proud.
Eat even more treats?
No, I'm gonna be strong. For now.
For now. We'll be back.
Some would say that's a feast for sore eyes. But in my experience, the mouth has the feast, not the eyes.
Now that my little hippogriff is hungry, I wonder if that would work. But first, let's go tell the red pirate that they have left the island. Give us the friggin' compass.
Good news.
Have they gone?
Certainly.
See?
It was hard work, but worth it for a magic compass.
What magic compass?
The one?
Spirit compass you promised me.
I don't remember that. Do you, Pierre?
What?
Nah, Pierre doesn't either.
You said you'd lend me the spirit compass if I got rid of the Van Burens.
So what? Did you hear me say pirate's word of honor?
Oh my god.
You... You didn't say pirate's word of honor.
Therefore, according to pirate law, no contract was entered into.
Oh my god.
You should have known that, Nate.
But I need the compass.
And I'm not going to hand it over that easily. You should have known that, too.
Okay, bring him back.
Out with him. And bolt the door.
Ugh. You're gonna regret this. What did you say, Pierre? Fat loony? I wouldn't dare say that.
Well, that was an exercise in futility.
A quite fierce, grim-looking ape is preventing that.
He's not an ape. He's an orangutan or something.
That thug bolted the gate after he threw me out. Just look at that. Thinks he's something special, just because he beat up a fully grown man. He's got the key. I don't want to get into a fight with him. Just look at that.
You want some seeds? Or, some food? How about I cover you with white powder? Or bash over the head with this thing? Okay, I'm out of stuff. Okay. So, I don't know what we can do with anything. Can we feed this? Or feed the hippo?
Would you like some of these sweets?
Whoa, Betty!
Mm.
Someone's got one hell of a sweet tooth.
Whole hand goes in.
I haven't got any more.
Huh?
There's about 200 weights of these unhealthy treats waiting for you over there, in front of the palace.
Huh?
Yes, go, but make sure you don't eat them all at once.
What? So, Critter.
Hey, Critter.
Huh?
Okay, never mind.
Forget it. I've got everything under control.
Tuk-a-look.
Tuk-a-look. And he's automatically back here with the tea. It's a hippogriff.
What have you done, little fella?
There's a lot of it gone.
The whole lot? How was that even... I mean, it's gotta have gone somewhere.
You look like you just pooped. What the hell? Is it pink poop?
That's the biggest, most formidable, and most glittery heap of dung I've ever seen.
I can take handfuls of it.
You want me to... That's...
Dung. The dung beetles.
It's still warm.
For the dung beetles. Yes. You happy now?
Yeah.
Not only is she blessed with an appetite, she's also got fantastic digestion.
Nah.
Nah.
Not only is she...
Nah.
This hippogriff dung in my bag is some of the most repulsive and stinky stuff I've ever carried around. And that includes the night I carried Stinky Pete home from the tavern.
Want some? Put it back in? No? All right, let's go. What if I put powder on it? We'll put some seeds in it? No? All right. So we're headed back.
Away we go.
Back to... Wait.
Cast
off. Back to Lorem Ipsum. Now we get to see him keep the thing on. Awesome. Okay. Now, I don't suppose we could just throw this stuff in here when it's dark, can we? Nope. Okay, Critter. In you go. I don't know why the game wouldn't let us put the rabbit ears on. He can have it on the whole time now. Throw a bit of hippo dung to the dung beetles.
Perhaps a little bit.
Okay. They seem to really like it.
That was a weird echo. That's Nate's voice.
I won't set a foot in the...
That strikes me.
More?
Perhaps they'll see me as a friend at some point and stop attacking me.
Or they'll kill you because they want to get to the rest of the dung.
Huh. Well, they never have attacked you.
Perhaps they'll see me as a friend at some point and stop attacking me.
Or they'll...
Is there any way to lure them off?
Those are elite. Did you know?
I won't set a foot in the room with those...
That strike...
What if I throw it on the statues? Would I go up on the statue? Yeah.
Thanks to Critter, I can see enough. And what I can see, I don't like.
I'm sure it'll stick. No? What am I supposed to do now? I got something to distract them. And I can't distract them. What if I put it on the stone ball? Will they destroy the ball? Look at that.
Delicious. At least I don't have to carry it around with me anymore. The dung beetles can smell the dung. They're very excited. They're running
move.
Back and forth on the walls of the hole.
Oh.
They're looking for a way to get to the ball.
I figured they could get to it, but...
The ball must weigh tons.
Burial chamber?
This needs to be plural. Dung beetles.
Is there any way to lure them off?
Those, did you?
I won't set...
That's...
There are some nasty-looking spikes waiting at the bottom of the pitfall, and some scarab beetles are scurrying around between them.
I would suggest...
How do I get them... over there?
Nothing's moving anymore.
To do with any of this stuff here. He still can't get in the room. How do we let them get through? We keep making tiny little progress here. Okay, we automatically go, okay. Let's go back to Seastone, I guess. Since we know they've gone there, maybe I can get something else. Another item to help me in my quest.
Away we go. After everything Ivo told me, Seastone is a no-go at the moment. Better that we're not seen there. His human version, I mean.
Never mind. We can't go there. Hold on. Critter, what do you have? Do you have anything good? Give this stuff back to Nate.
Thank you.
Maybe you can put a plank over the wall. I'm not sure exactly how high that wall is, because it cuts away.
Thank you.
But supposedly, Nate can see those statues in the room. So.
Let's see you, little girl. Mm-hmm.
The plank. Put the plank over the pit at an angle. Oh, right, they can go through here, they just need to get up. So, frame rate hitting. Wow. Run, my little workers.
Run, my little workers. Okay. Go forth and get yourselves the mother of all dung balls.
They gonna eat the whole thing into pieces?
Together, they're strong.
Oh, they're making it roll.
However, not very clever.
Rent. Awesome. We're free to enter the room. And look at the stone gate. Let's look at the stone gate. I'm sure we can't just open it. Just look at it.
Let me guess. The Pharaoh's burial chamber is behind this door.
Burial chamber?
Yes, it is.
Well, he remembers it
this
time.
How do you open it?
You have to... Have you given it a good tug yet?
I guess you need to turn this disc to open the door. However, that's exactly what these two metal pins are preventing. I guess you need to turn...
Okay.
Thanks to Critter, I can see enough.
Alright, let's enter the room. Finally get into this friggin' room.
Alright then, what happens here?
Doom. Oops. What was that all about? So, we can look at the board.
Board full of small stone discs. Looks a bit like a board game.
Behind such boards, we used to hide treasures back in the day.
That thing's a safe of sorts?
Indeed. If you manage to move the figure to one of the treasure fields, the board will flip open. There are pitfalls and fields that turn into pitfalls after they have been stepped on. You can't step on spiky fields, but the golem can. He will move towards your figure if you are standing in a straight line to him.
All right. And anyone can open the safe if he wins the game?
Well, some think that a thief that goes through the trouble of solving the puzzle has earned the right to do some looting. Personally, I never agreed with that.
Alright, before we start playing that little mini game here, let's look at the wheel.
A wheel in the wall. Judging by its position, I'd say it opens the grate next to it.
Quite right. We had blind slaves who cared for the basilisks.
Basilisks?
They were only allowed to open the enclosures when all others had left the room.
This thing can still bite you.
The basilisks don't need the wheel anymore.
Okay, so we have a wheel.
A grate, and some kind of enclosure behind it. But it doesn't look as if there's much danger lying in wait for me. There are only a couple of skeletons on the floor.
What has happened to the basilisks?
I'm no zoologist, but it might be problematic if you don't feed basilisks for a few thousand years.
But the scarabs survived.
Exactly my point.
Yeah, but that's because there's enough shit in this world.
I don't know there's that much. Alright. Oh, I can take the chisel now.
A hand wheel to manually open the basilisk enclosure.
Lever.
Something happened. And now it's been reversed again.
Wait, I see that. One of the pins went through. Opening the board.
Alrighty then. I'll try my luck.
Alrighty.
No! This present does not belong to you.
Not yet.
Present?
Read, fool. Present of the Pharaoh to his favorite concubine, Star of the East.
Ooh, that sounds like gold, gems, finest jewelry.
Huck-neg! Huck-neg!
What?
What are you doing?
I will continue to make this noise as long as you try to steal from the Pharaoh's favorite concubine.
What?
She must have been dead for thousands of years.
Huck, Nick.
Okay, okay. Just a quick one, one or two moves.
Huck, Nick. Huck, Nick. Why are you stopping?
As you said, Huck Nag.
Just a quick one. What?
Huck? Why?
Alright. Let's come on out. Let's get the chisel. We could use it for something else.
Why not? A simple bronze chisel. Sharp, too.
Are you tired yet, critter?
The door's opened a little.
Critter might be able to use some of this stuff. Walking all over the place. Come the hammer.
Here, for you.
Come the chisel.
Take this.
And...
here. You might need this more than me.
Ah, that's... sounds promising.
That would be quite funny. Take this. Now... Critter is a...
not much of a linguist. Alright. Switch back to Critter, and then let's see if we can get some of the stuff in here. This lever. I already tried the chisel, didn't I? I don't know then. Huh. If we cover the holes in the wall with something, we'll just disarm the trap somehow. Let's have him look at the stone gate. Critter can play the game. What?
At a time when most other humans were still living in mud huts, they were creating very delicate stonework here. Impressive. Of course, we elves were already living in multi-story houses,
what?
Had 60 strong orchestras and comprehensive health cover. But for humans, not bad.
What the hell?
At a time when, of course, but for humans.
Okay, definitely a bug. That's Ivo's voice. Alright. Have Nate look at the door.
I guess you need to turn this disc to open the door. One of the stone pins is out, just the second one to go. I guess you... one of the...
Why does he have to jump all the way through? Can't he just stay there? He doesn't know what to do with it. I can't play the game with him. I thought I could. Alright. I'm gonna deliberate on this. I mean, if we can put the mummy down, set him over here, we can stop it from driving Nate crazy so Nate can play the game. Well, thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.